Hello everyone, I'm Abhishek from Team Robocart, and today in this lecture we are going to learn about how you can develop your own applications. And the website which we are going to use is code.org. So let's open code.org and start. So before using this website, we have to create our own account. For creating an account, click on this sign in option. Now we can see that there are multiple options, but we have to click on create an account for creating an account. Now we will continue with Google, so click on continue with Google. Select a Gmail account. Now I already have an account, so it is directly getting signed in, but you have to answer some basic questions like your name, your school's name. It will ask for account type. Select account type teacher and type public. Then you can create your own account, and now you will be able to see your name over here on the right hand side corner. After this, for creating our own applications, we have to open App Lab. If you are not able to find App Lab over here, you have to click on View All Projects. Scroll down a bit and then click on View Full List. In this Beyond Blocks option, you will be able to find this App Lab. Double click to open the App Lab. Now in the App Lab we have three main parts. The first one is workspace where I will write my code. Now for writing this code I can use this toolboxes, I can use this tool, or else I can type my own code using this. Is my screen where I can simulate the actual output. Whatever code I will write over here, I can see the actual simulation over here on this screen. Over here we have three options: code, design and data. So in code we can write our own code, in design we can design our application, and in data we can store data from the application. Now let's start with designing part. So if I am clicking on three properties, ID, background color and email. So we can set the ID of the screen. ID means what we are going to call this screen in the actual program. Whatever we are going to call this screen in the actual code, we will write that in the ID. Background color, I can change the background color of my screen. Also, I can add an image in my screen. I can add an image as a search for, you can download any image you want as the background. I am using this Robocards logo as my background. So I will save this image in my computer. Desktop. Now let's use this image as my background. So for that we have to click on choose, then upload a file, then select the file which we want to upload. Logo. Open this file and just click on choose, and this image will be as your background. I hope this thing is clear to everyone. Now let's proceed with how I can add some buttons and how I can program them. So for now we are creating a very basic application. Okay, so first I am taking a button. Now we are creating a simple application so that when I click on this button I can see my name. When I am clicking on this button, I can see my name over here. So I am clicking a button on my screen. Click on the button first and then you can change the ID. I am keeping the ID as name. And the text is my name. Now I can increase the size of this button just by dragging it. Click on the right hand side corner, bottom corner, and then you can change the size accordingly. Click here to know my name is the text and the ID is name. ID is what we are going to call it in the actual program. Now for displaying this, I am using a label. Increase the size of the label. The ID is label 1, I am not changing the ID for now. and text is blank. I'm just increasing the border width. The border width is 4 now. That's it. We have just added two things, a button. The ID of the button is name and the text is click here to know my name, and a label, and the ID of the label is label 1. Text is blank. I'm just adding a border width of 4. Now let's see. Let's start with the coding part. For that, click on code first, and then we are using the first block. On event, this name is click. Name is the ID of this button. So which means on event, when I am clicking on this button, we have to set text. We have to set text of my label 1. To avoid spelling mistake, please select the IDs by clicking on this drop down. The text is, you can write your name. I am writing Robocard for now. On even this name button is click, I am setting my text. I am setting the text of my label to Robocard. Let's see how it works. If I click on run, and if I click on this button, Robocard. Now see, the name is not properly aligned because the block is too small. So go to design and increase the size a bit. And let's click on run again. Yeah, now it's perfect. Similarly, you can create your own application. You can display whatever you want. You can display your name, your field name and standard, your email ID and things like that. Also, let me show you how you can use a simple button to open a website. Now let's see how we can make a COVID tracker application. Before that, you have to upload a short video of your application's output to a mobile phone application, robocard.com. Now, to submit your applications to us, you have to mail us the application on my mail ID. You have to mail us the link. To get a link, click on share and you can get a link. Copy this link and you can paste this link to our mail ID, support@robocard.com. Also, you have to record a small video of your output of your application and upload the video on our mobile phone application, which is free of cost. The link will be there in the description. So please click on the link and download the application to participate in the competition. Now in the mail, you have to write your name, your application's name, a small description about your application and an image for logo, and we will upload your application on Play Store live for you from our account. So the best applications, we will upload them on the Play Store and we will give you proper credits for your applications. Okay, so please submit your links to us on support@robocard.com. Also, upload the output video on our free mobile phone application. The link will be there in the description. Now let's start with the second application, a COVID tracker app. I'm just showing you how you can open a link by using a simple button. For that, I'm opening a new app lab. You can rename your project. This was first application and then I can click on save to save this project. And just click on share, copy this link and paste it wherever you want and you will be able to share your application. Now let's see how you can make a COVID tracker app. I'm opening a new app lab. Similarly, in designs, you can select the change the background color and select a proper image for the pandemic tracker or COVID tracker. I am using the same image. I am taking the first button on my screen. This button is used for showing the India's COVID count. So the ID is India and text is COVID count in India. Change the size of the button accordingly. And when I click on this button, I will open a URL. Let's search for it. COVID count in India. COVID count in India. This information is there on this website. So I'm copying the link. Control C to copy this link. And on event this India button is clicked, I will just open this URL. For that, the last block in UI controls, URL, open URL, and we have to paste the URL which we have just copied from here. So I am just pasting this URL, control V. Now let's see how it works. If I click on run and if I click on this button, it will automatically open the URL to show the number of COVID patients, active COVID patients in India. Similarly, you can add multiple buttons to show precautions, cases around the world and things like that. You can use your own logic and you can build your own interesting application. Don't forget to share the link with us on our mail ID. Also upload the output video on our Hore application. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. RoboCard is available on all leading social media platforms. So follow us on Instagram and Facebook for updates like this. And share this video with your friends and family. Don't forget to hit that like button. Thank you so much for watching the video. Bye everyone. Take care.